Hey guys, and welcome back to yet another episode. On today's show, I wanted to talk about something a little special, something I don't see folks talk about a lot on YouTube, and that is the awesome Neo Geo ports on the PC Engine for the arcade CD-ROM. Now, four of these were released as far as Neo Geo arcade ports go, and let me tell you guys, all four of these are really excellent ports. So let's go through real quick, and I'll show you guys the four that were released, and we can kind of talk about each one for just a minute here. So first one we see right here in front, this is Art of Fighting. This is the original game. You can see this here. Now the arcade card games require, as you can see here, the Arcade Card Duo or Arcade Card Pro, depending on which system you have. If you have the Duo, you want to get the Duo card, and if you have the briefcase unit or the classic unit, you want to go with the Arcade Card Pro. From my experience, it doesn't seem to really matter too much. I've been able to use both cards on both systems with no major issues. But anyway, so now we're going to pop open Art of Fighting. As you can see, there's a registration card, a spine card, and all that in there as well. And while we're taking a look at this too, I'll also put some gameplay up on the screen so you guys can check out how good this particular port looks of Art of Fighting. Really cool how they try to kind of make do with the sort of artificial scaling that they tried to do to sort of copy how the Neo Geo game worked. Kind of an interesting concept on the PC Engine. Very, very cool. Anyway, the next game in the list is going to be Fatal Fury 2. Awesome cover art on this one as well. I really, really like the cover. On the back, you see the same kind of thing. On the arcade card games, you'll always see one of these little diagrams telling you all about the arcade card. This particular version might be my favorite, or one of my favorite home versions of Fatal Fury 2. It's, if you compare it to the Sega Genesis and Super Nintendo versions, I think it easily bests both of those. The Super NES version is probably my favorite between the Super NES and Genesis, but I do think that the PC Engine version is just a little bit better in the graphics and sound department. Just a little bit closer to the original. The next game is a personal favorite of mine. This is Fatal Fury Special. Again, really cool cover art on this one as well. This, in my opinion, is probably the best version of Fatal Fury Special that you could get at home back at the time. Obviously, this is before the compilation discs and things like that that came along later with the arcade Neo Geo versions on them. But this particular version of Fatal Fury Special, I think, is better than the Super NES one and the Sega CD version by quite a bit. And another really interesting and kind of a cool thing about these games, they're really, really cheap. You can still get them for usually under about $20 a piece. So if you're looking at some really cool PC Engine fighting games, these are definitely ones to look at. The only catch being, obviously, that you're going to have to pony up for one of the memory cards, either the Pro or the Duo. And again, in my experience, I would say go for the Duo. That one is usually cheaper in most cases. I personally have the Arcade Card Pro, and that one's worked out well for me, but I got lucky with that one back when I got it and ended up getting a really good deal on it. I think these days, the Pros go for around $150 to $200. So yeah, ouch. Last one we're gonna talk about is World Heroes 2. This is my favorite of the World Heroes series as well. I'm a big fan of the World Heroes games, but 2 is just, there's something special about it. Again, look at this cover art. It is so cool. I love that they put Jan in the front too. That's super awesome. So let's crack this one open here. Take a look. The CD itself is pretty plain looking, as you can see. Not a whole lot going on there, but at least the instructions are all full of really great artwork. Again, you can see the back looks very similar to the other ones. And let's just pop this out real quick just to see. I believe that all these are full color manuals, but I just want to double check and see. Well, sort of. It's just sort of like a slip cover, and then inside, at least for World Heroes anyway, it sort of folds out into like kind of a poster. But what's cool is check out this poster. It's got all the characters on it and all the moves in full color. Very, very cool. You know what? Just to check, let's see if, because it's been so long since I've opened these up, let's see if the other ones are like that too. So I'm going to go ahead and open up Fatal Fury Special. Actually, this one's a little different. This one's just kind of a traditional manual, but check it out. Really cool artwork. It's in color as well. With full move lists. This is a pretty thick instruction manual too. And it shows you how to play on, like, you know, whether you use the 3 button or the Avenue Pad 6. Which really, it's the only way to play these games. Get the Avenue Pad 6. But yeah, so even the instruction books on these games are, you know, super high quality. So, like I said, I can't recommend these enough, you know, if you are looking for reasonably priced PC Engine fighting games. You really can't go wrong with the Neo Geo ports on the arcade CD. They are great. I remember the first time I played them, I was really blown away by how close they were compared to the Neo Geo originals. Pretty mind-blowing, the stuff that the PC Engine was able to do, especially late in its lifespan. When you look at stuff like this and games like, you know, Street Fighter II Champion Edition, things like that, it really was an amazing machine. But anyway, I've wanted to talk about these 4 games for a while because they really are excellent, and I can't recommend them highly enough. So if you get the chance and you have the arcade card, definitely give these a try. They are fantastic. And as always, guys, you know what to do. Until next time, stay classic.